video is about admissions in Japan. In this video, we are going to cover these three questions. Question number one, why study in Japan? Question number second, how to save money in Japan, how to be cost effective in Japan? And question number three, about the admission processing, the processing of COE and visa. This is part one, and in the later video, we'll cover the other questions like how can we be very effective in study, Japanese language studies in Japan. So this video will cover these three questions mainly. Welcome to Nihongomax. My name is Ravi. So let's start. So the first question is, why study in Japan? The main reason is to improve your employability. When a student goes to Japan and studies Japanese language, he gets twice faster growth in terms of Japanese language and cultural knowledge compared to studying Japanese in India or in any other country through textbooks or any material. It is always seen that the student becomes very fluent in spoken Japanese within 1 month after landing in Japan. The second most important reason is regular conversation with Japanese native, regular listening of real Japanese, for example in malls, railway station, general stores, while partying with friends or even traveling to various places. Japan has one foot firmly rooted in East Asian culture, and they also have strong influence of Western and American culture. So the cultural experience, the international experience and fluent Japanese language gives you many opportunities for your employability. Because most Japanese companies want a foreigner who can not only talk to a Japanese in Japanese language, but also with the proper cultural knowledge and the business mannerisms of Japan. Japan is also the home of some of the most, I would say, world's leading tech companies such as Sony, Nikon, Canon, Hitachi, Toyota, Honda, Mitsubishi, Nissan. The list is endless. Japan is a safe, peaceful and I would say healthy food country where cleanliness is always appreciated by any visitor. Japan is a symbol of futuristic technology blend of very old traditions and culture. Like, you can go to Kyoto in a bullet train to visit a temple of golden pavilion covered in gold leaf, which creates a breathtaking reflection of sunlight surrounded by beautiful nature, and the same time just going to the toilet in a metro station in Japan, it can be your very excellent technological experience. And at the same time, Japan is also a very traditional society. It is very safe country with almost no crime. Japanese people are cooperative, well-mannered, punctual, honest, hardworking. But they also expect you to behave in a similar manner. If you are a foreigner, you have to follow the same cultural rules that Japanese follow in Japan. So there is so much to do in Japan, like onsen, karaoke, bowling, ryoko. But only once you get to know the place and the Japanese language better. While living in Japan, you have to follow every rule and discipline very strictly. Like, for example, smoking everywhere is not allowed. There are separate smoking zones at every different place. No one throws garbage on roads, so you can see Japan be 100% clean every time. No one stares at girls, no matter what they are wearing. No one break the queues. Even people give way to others on escalators by being on one side of it. So it's very competent society. It's very excellent society to learn, and not only Japanese language, but the international culture also. For example, Japan's service is among the best in the world. Food is excellent. Even if you go to a cheap place or just buy some discounted ready food in the evening at the local supermarket, nowhere else you can see such food and such good service, such unlimited shopping and crazy activities in such a safe and polite environment. It is hard to fully grasp Japan, even if you have to be there for a long time, for 1 year or for 2 years. There will always be much more to discover. So let's come upon the second question, second point, how to save money while studying Japanese language in Japan. Okay, whenever I tell people about my experience of studying Japanese language in Japan, everyone quickly asks the same question: isn't Japan very expensive? So I tell everyone that 1 year cost of living and studying Japanese in Japan is half compared to US, UK, Canada or Australia. So I would say the idea that Japan is an expensive place does not exist actually. It's a myth. So keep watching this video before you go to Japan. It pays you to start your money saving efforts long before actually when you set foot in Japan. For example, picking the right processing agent is the most effective way to save money, as they will tell you many things. For example, when should you go to Japan, and how to start your journey to be optimum in terms of cost effectiveness. For example, in case of Tokyo, it can be very expensive to live there compared to Tokushima, Osaka, Takamatsu or other cities of Japan. Be it property prices, rented apartment, traveling, fooding, Tokyo is among the highest expensive cities in the world. That's why it might make sense to pick a smaller city or a remote area to study Japanese language in Japan if one of your goals is to save money while studying Japanese. Luckily, there are many affordable types of accommodation and jobs available in other cities, especially for foreign students. So this is the first and most important point to save money in Japan. And now let's understand how to save money once you reach Japan. Studying in Japan can pay you different international and Japanese language culture experiences that you can convert into money by using it in getting jobs. So start with a part-time job and go for shopping. Japanese cities are quite bicycle friendly. So consider yourself buying yourself a cheap bicycle, or you can rent it instead of using expensive forms of public transport. Anyone who has lived in Japan will agree that the nearest 100 yen shop, yes, this term you should understand first, 100 yen shop, like for example Daiso or Aeon, they quickly become your friend, because anything you might need, right from kitchenware, stationery tools, household items, candies, chocolates, beer, or a very cute piggy bank. All is lined up there on a very reasonable price. And of course, just don't get tempted by all the kawaii, that means funny, items that you don't actually need, because we are quickly tempted to them. So first save your money, first understand, first study, and then start expending your money. So when you start living in Japan, for example, ask any Japanese about different hidden ways and they will quickly tell you about how to save your money by just filling a simple form. For example, government is providing the same thing on a very cheap price. If we focus about price, one will never regret about the amount he has paid for any product purchased, be it an expensive one. Because of its quality and durability, be it a food item, electronic item, stationery, household good. Similarly, when it comes to eating out, Japan really offers a wide range of options and prices. Restaurants can be expensive or they can be surprisingly cheap, depending on where you go and what is the time. About the busy shopping malls, and look for the smaller restaurants hidden in the streets, in the alleyways. For less than 400 yen, you can get yourself a steamy rice bowl, curry rice or a noodle dish. There is no culture of giving tips, so this is an added advantage while being in a restaurant in Japan. However, cooking your own food will ultimately save you more money, as long as you learn how to shop smart, or as fast as you can learn by cooking yourself. A great way to avoid pricey groceries is shopping late and locally. As I told that, ask a Japanese where I can purchase this item on the lowest price. These markets basically offer better prices than convenience stores, and at the end of the day, you'll find a lot great deals on veggies, meat, fish in these supermarkets. Another way to budget in Japan is by looking at what the locals eat. Discover new ingredients like kabocha, daikon. Kabocha and daikon are names of veggies, Japanese veggies. And take note when they come into the season. Getting yourself big bag of rice, a bottle of mirin, that is cooking wine, and the good supply of soya sauce, three essentials. These are cook a simple Japanese dish. It will take some time, but it will make you proficient, it will make you good. If you start cooking yourself a Japanese food, a Japanese dish, it would be worth to put efforts to master new recipes. But you will surely be able to impress friends and family back home by whipping up your own Japanese dish in a very low budget, if you can only put your effort for the initial first month, or I would say initial 2 months, very earnestly. So in the end, I would say that Japan is a compatible country with the student lifestyle, and experience you'll gain in this mesmerizing country will be almost certainly priceless. So let's now quickly jump on the third question. Admission processing for study visa for Japan. Usually the student visa processing for Japanese language course in Japan may take around 6 months for the whole procedure, starting from documentation verification, guarantor verification, POS approval, ID number generation, COE issuance. COE is certificate of eligibility, then COA, certificate of admission, and then you have to again apply for the visa in your local embassy. This procedure starts with applying to Japanese university and being accepted by them after interview, including a number of visa related documents approval. There are many points that the applicant must be careful about, like the name spelling and the essay you are writing about your future must match your vision with the past experience or with your past education. And while applying for the Japan visa in your home country, in your local embassy, you have to again be very careful about the same points. And there are mainly two intakes, April and October. For most Japanese schools in Japan, they take only in April and October. Some of them take in June or January also, but the starting dates, again, I would say it takes around 6 months to start the process for them. But they don't offer the cheap courses. For long-term courses on student visa, you need to apply approximately 6 months in advance, and to most language schools, due to the lengthy visa application procedure. For example, if you want to study in Semmon Gakko, or I would say in English it is a technical course in Japan, you'll usually need to take a Japanese language exam to show that you can fulfill their requirements. The fee is higher as compared to language study. The language study is the cheapest course in Japan, and the Semmon Gakko I was telling about usually demands the JLPT level of N2 with the particular experience in the field you are going to apply in. For example, I'm going to apply in engineering field, so you need to have the experience of studying around 3 to 4 years with N2, JLPT N2, Japanese language proficiency test. So that is the different path. For example, Nihongomax specializes in making students take admission in Japanese language courses in Japan. So we help you to apply in school in schools in Japan without having troubles of documentation or deadlines. And there is many other things to tell you. There are many things to tell you, but I hope I'm able to give you some of the basic information in this video. We'll cover the other information, other important questions about studying Japan in our upcoming videos. So keep watching our channel, Nihongomax. Thank you so much.